Crap! That's an engine failure. We need to lose weight. Open the door and throw everything out. Save yourself! Jump out!
Lucky. Falling in the deep snow probably saved your life. You see those targets through the blizzard? Head over there. Okay, let's get familiar with how the controllers are set up. Press the buttons indicated.
Hey, I'm Les Stroud. Look, I'm gonna be honest with you. This isn't good at all. But I've been through a lot worse. The reality is that every decision you make right now is one of life or death. And here's the good news. I'll be right here with you. Good luck.
Take a look at the watch on your left hand. Your biometric watch will keep track of important information that'll keep you alive. Like your core body temperature. It's pretty cold up here. Tap the face of the watch. When you're cold and hungry, it's easy to lose focus. This list of priorities will help keep you on track. This is what dying looks like. Your tunnel vision, you can hardly move. It's game over when you get to this state. That paint on the rock is a great landmark. Use it to find your way back.
Hey, listen. I've done some location scouting for you. Come over here and check this out. Look at this. This is a perfect spot to get your fire going. Got a rock wall in behind it that's going to reflect a lot of heat back at you throughout the night. And behind me here, look at this. An excellent cave. It's a windbreak. That's really important. You want to get out of the wind. You always have to have some kind of surface you can work on. And this little spot right here is going to be perfect. By the way, the next most important thing is to get warm. You don't want to become hypothermic. You need to get a fire going. Here. Take my knife. It's got a flint strike.
All right, now try it out. Strike the blade of the knife across the flint. See those sparks? Yeah, that's how you're gonna start your fire. Put your knife on your belt and keep it there at all times. Now you're thinking. That's gonna work.
Yeah, perfect. That'll work.
could grab. Lip balm. It's made out of wax. That'll work well. It's a great accelerator.
You can smear some of the wax onto the paper to help it burn.
All right, your winter boots made it. Well, hold on. Just one of them.
You can use that as tinder. Bad books make great fire starters.
Aftershave. See, now you're thinking survival. That's 70% alcohol.
brutal storm, wasn't it?
Looks like the blizzard's gone for now, though. And look at you. You got a fire going. Congratulations. What are you looking at?
Ah, that chopper up there? That's tempting, isn't it?
Think about this. What if someone up there is still alive? You have priorities, though. You want to think about your zones of assessment. What's around your body? What's close at hand? What's further afield? You got options now. Survival options. Make a choice. It's your call. Just remember, the choice you make is always going to be life or death.
Don't get too ambitious when it comes to gathering supplies. This is pretty deep snow. If you push too hard, you'll exhaust yourself. The snow's up to your waist here. It takes incredible effort to walk through snow this deep. You're punching through the snow. This isn't working. Don't just scramble up there. If you sweat, you die. When you sweat, you get wet. And if you get wet in windy conditions, just like here, you lose a lot of body heat very fast.
Come here, check this out. See that plastic crate? Yeah, I'll bet you could use that. But that is one treacherous location.
We slip from there, and you're going all the way down.
Game over.
So how can you get out there? How are you going to get that? Try doing it without killing yourself.
A smashed crate from the helicopter. That's gonna work. Piece of the helicopter. Okay, I see something here you're gonna need. Unscrew those hose clamps using your knife. Don't forget that crate. Looking a little cold to me. Better get back to the fire.
better stay here for a second and warm up. You see that ring around the base of the fire? That's the fuel gauge. When you only see a little bit of it left, it's time to gather some more wood.
Hey, look at all that great stuff you've got there. I bet you can make something out of this. You know what? If you're gonna try to get up to that chopper, you're gonna punch through the snow. You have to increase the surface area that you're walking on. So why don't you turn all of this into snowshoes? Here, I've got the other boot for you.
A green outline, it means the item is in the correct position. Take the knife out and cut off the side walls. Now center your boot on the crate. Now you can use the hose clamps to attach the boot to the crate. Good work. You've just made yourself some snowshoes. To put them on, just bring them closer to your body. These hack snowshoes should do the trick. You're not punching through the deep snow anymore. I think you can make it up to the helicopter now. Backpack is an awesome find. Just bring the backpack closer to your body to put it on. Reach over your shoulder to retrieve it again. You can put your found items. Watch your head. Press the X button to crouch and enter. Awesome idea in pulling that compass out. Now you can take a bearing, set a heading, get yourself off this mountain. Good, that's a piece of cotton. Get everything and get out. It's true. That's going to be useful. For something. That padded foam seat looks comfortable. You may want to sleep on that, but it's too big for your backpack. It's working now, but batteries don't last long in the cold. Yeah, that's perfect. It's a great idea. Now put it on your head. Stay warm. A tin box. Perfect. I can show you a trick with that. But you need to find something organic. Some kind of fabric. Nothing plastic. It might not be a big meal. But just the same, a couple of granola bars, that'll get you through to the next day. It's just enough calories to keep you moving. Water bottle. This will make hydration easier. Fortunately, in this environment, water isn't that scarce, so it's one less concern you have for survival. A long pole like that will always be useful. I put it in the backpack. Exposed skin can freeze in minutes, maybe even seconds up here. You better head back to the fire.
All right, this fire's going to die. You're gonna need some more fuel.
All right, now let me show you a really useful survival skill. How to make charred cloth. You're gonna have to grab that little mint tin you found in the chopper. Fabric you have in the tin.
Take the tin, poke a small hole in the top, and drop it into the fire. In that tin, you're creating what's called charred cloth. It only takes a few minutes. It's one of the best tinders you can use to get a fire going again. You won't be able to sleep on that cold ground. It'll sap the heat from your body. You need an insulator between you and the ground. I think that seat from the helicopter should do the trick. Did you grab it? All right, let's get up. I know you've had a shitty night. Trust me, I know. Been there, done that. No time to waste now. You have to get off this mountain while the day is still ahead of you. Pack up your camp, check your priorities, and make sure you've gathered everything you need.
Gotta go. And that looks treacherous. So take this half-shell suitcase, use it like a sled. Now pull. You can use that as a brake to slow yourself down, or steer with it. I'd much rather you have an ice axe for a situation like this. But you don't have one. So use the pull. Yeah. Yeah, good luck with that. I'll see you at the bottom!
Oh, that was a crazy ride. I'm not so sure everything came with you in that backpack.
You're standing in a very dangerous place. This is the top of a massive glacier. It's a river of ice that never stops moving. And as it moves, it creates dangerous cracks and crevices that'll swallow you whole. Let's have a listen. It sounds like a beast moaning, doesn't it? Want to know the worst thing about it? That blizzard covered over all of the cracks and crevices, so now we can't even see them. Come with me. I want to show you something.
Hey, check this out. What do you see? Yeah, me too. Nothing but white. There's a trick to it. You can tell where the cracks and crevices are by noticing the textures and the patterns of the snow. But if you've got a pole, you can take that test further. Watch. That's good and solid. Let's try here. Yep, that's good. So we can walk here. Whoa, all right. There we go. That exposes a hole. So you want to take your pole and use it to test the snow in front of you. Not this pole. Get your own.
Orange perimeter, that's out of bounds. Cross that line, and you die. Some kind of weather rolling in. Out here on the glacier with no shelter is not good. Pretty soon you won't be able to see 5 feet in front of you. I've put a marker up ahead for you. Take a bearing on it and remember that bearing. Use your compass. Okay, if you drop the pole, I'll put it back in your backpack. You're going to need it.
I want to make sure you don't get lost. I'd put another marker up ahead. Use your compass, take a bearing, and remember it. Hours and hours of walking in the Arctic wasteland, you end up staring straight down. And if it gets too white outside with blizzards and wind and the snow underneath your feet, it starts to feel like you're walking on the inside of a ping pong ball. You can walk right off the edge of a cliff.
That is a long ways down, but you can get down there safely. You see that spool? Remember it? You threw it out of the chopper. That can work as rope. It'll hold your body weight, but you've got to anchor it to something strong. What do you think you have that you could sacrifice?
Normally, a mountain climber would use something called a climbing chuck in a situation like this. That's a chunk of strong aluminum or steel to wedge in that crack. Or they might use an ice screw to screw into the ice. But you don't have either. So what do you have that's small enough to fit in that crack and strong enough to hold your weight? All right, you're gonna sacrifice your knife. I know that sucks, but sometimes survival and sacrifice go hand in hand. Now wedge the knife in the crack and loop the cable around it. All right, you can't just go down a rope hand over hand. Not too many of us are that strong. That really only works in video games. So I've attached a couple... Rappelling down a rope, you should only use a prussic knot as a backup to proper rappelling equipment. This is all you have. So hold on to the top and bottom knots, and you'll see how this works. One by one, each knot can slip down the rope while the other holds you. It's a lot of work. We're down at a lower altitude now. It's several degrees warmer and much less windy. Yes, some wire. That can come in very, very handy.
Hey, welcome to the Arctic tundra. Now, I know what you see, barren land. I see opportunity. There's lots here that'll help you survive. Mosses, grasses, berries, even game you can catch. So get busy surviving this Arctic desert.
At 48 hours with no food, you're becoming lethargic. You're low on energy. There's lots of vitamins in these, but they're best to eat if you boil them. Bearberries. It's late in the season, but these are still good.
Hey, take a look at these. See that? It's a very faint trail, but you can spot it. Here's another one. And there's a third. Now notice how they all converge together. Now these are Arctic hare trails. And right in that spot where they come together, perfect place to set up a snare. First, you're going to have to find something to snare with.
A snare is simply a loop that an animal goes through, catches on it, and the loop closes in on itself. You need to hang a wire loop right over this spot. Now, what are you going to hang it from? Now grab a few rocks and secure the pole. Then make a wall to funnel the prey into the snare. When the prey runs, you want to funnel them right into your snare. Grab some rocks and make a wall to lead them in. Now that's a pretty good snare. Let's hope you get lucky. Using a snare is a waiting game. It's actually the good thing about it. It's passive hunting. You set them up, and you walk away. Excellent work. Where are you going? You left your snare.
Take a look over there. What do you see?
I know what you're thinking. You see nothing. You have to pay attention to the landscape. Right now, you're used to seeing only natural features. So what looks out of place over there? See the straight lines? I'll bet you that's some kind of hunt camp. I'll bet you it's a structure. But how do you get to it from here?
This river's only half frozen. Super dangerous. The ice on the edge is not trustworthy. Use your pull to make sure it's solid before you take a step.
getting a fire going. Caribou skull. The herds migrate through here, and that's a good thing, because people follow caribou.
Huh? Huh? Am I right? Oh, come on. What are you looking at? To me, this is a palace, my friend. This is an abandoned old hunting and fishing camp. You can see everything around here is rusted, broken down, but that means that it's a place of opportunity and gathering for you. So start looking now. There's all kinds of junk around this place, and every single piece of it is going to help you survive.
Okay, if you're going to start a fire with charred cloth, you're going to need a few things. Number one, a perfectly prepared fire to light up. That means wood and tinder. There's always plant material in the tundra, and it can make great tinder. Look at your list of priorities and follow them in order. Okay, that's a well-prepared fire. Now you've got your charred cloth. So how are we going to light it? Here's a little clue. It's the hottest part of the day. Peak solar radiation. You'll need a lens. Now where can you find a lens? Use one of the rocks lying around to smash the lens out of the camera. Now this can be really hard to do. You need to focus the sun to the smallest spot you can. All right, you've got an ember in there now. Throw in at least 3 pieces of seed fluff, the more the better, and blow on it.
That's a great flame. Now quickly light up the fire before you burn up all the tinder.
You got it. We may have a fire and something to eat, but we need a grill to cook it. I think I saw one in the cabin.
grill. Perfect. This will make cooking so much easier.
Don't you just love a good mug of hot chocolate? Sorry, that's just me. You don't have any. But you've done me proud just the same. You came down off the mountain, crossed a glacier, traversed the Arctic tundra, even got yourself across a treacherous river. And that's tough. And now you're sitting here with your belly full of Arctic hair. Well, way to go. But you know that canoe you found? We're going to leave that until tomorrow, because right now you need something more important. You need to sleep. Exhaustion will kill you. So close your eyes and get some rest. You've earned it. Oh, nice fire, by the way.
Good morning. There's caribou migrating through here, so there's got to be some dung. See if you can find some old, dry caribou dung, and I'll show you a trick. In the tin. Now put a little bit of charcoal in with that.
you close up the tin, the little bit of oxygen getting in there should keep the dung smoldering for hours. You can now carry your fire. I think we can make a paddle from your pole. Use the axe and chop up some of those planks. If you only had a pin or a bolt of some kind, then you could fasten the paddle blade to the pole more securely. There's got to be something like that around this cabin. In fact, yes, some wire. That can come in very, very handy.
Looks like it'll float, but whoever owns it didn't leave a paddle. You'll need one if you want to take this canoe downriver. Okay, now wire it all together. Good work. Now let's get down the river. I suggest you'll have a better shot at being rescued on the coast. Stay right down the center when you're paddling a river like this. Thank you. Look at all that Arctic char. Wish you had some fishing gear. Less desolate than the way it was up on the top of that mountain. Lots of fish, lots of birds. That's a good sign.
Hey, you made it down. Fantastic, but now you want to be rescued, don't you? So it's all about being seen. There may be someone who spots you from the air or from the water, maybe even a lone hunter coming over a hill. I'm thinking big signal fire. Yeah, there's all kinds of driftwood lying around here. So, get busy.
Plastic is littering beaches all over the planet, but the benefit in survival is that it's made out of hydrocarbons and burns black, and that's great for a signal fire.
This could be a good spot for your fire. It's a bit sheltered. It can still be seen from the water.
See the orange perimeter? That's out of bounds. Cross that line, and you die.
Now let's see how big this fire can get. You want a large, smoky signal fire. Go get more fuel. Don't move. All right, you startled her, and she bolted. She's gone now, probably not for long. She'll come back when she realizes that her lunch is still here. Hey, you hear that? Is that what I think it is? Yes, it is. So quick, build up your fire. Grab the dead seal and get back to camp. The fatty blubber in that animal will create thick black smoke. That's hard to move, isn't it? But 100 pounds of slippery dead seal. Thank you.
Can you hear that? That, my friend, is the sweet sound of rescue. You learned. You didn't panic. You didn't give up. Man, you've nailed this survival thing. So, go ahead. Go home. Get yourself warm and comfortable. And I'll see you next time on another survival adventure.
Rescued on the coastline. I'll be there to guide you, though, every step of the way.